The following is a special presentation of the Decibel Geek Podcast.
This is the Decibel Geek Podcast with Chris Sinzak and Aaron. Finally upon us. No, seriously this time. Welcome to the Decibel Geek Podcast, and it is KISSmas in July. Time to celebrate. I'm your host, Aaron Camaro. Another host right there, Chris Sinzak. Together we bring you this show every week, and we're excited that it's our favorite time of year once again.
Yep, talking about the hottest band in the land.
That's right. We do it every year in the month of July.
Are we ready to get into today's topic?
Yeah, we are so excited to be bringing you KISSmas in July once again. You know, like we said, after all these years of doing it, it's like, what are we going to do? Right. What are we going to talk about that we haven't talked about with KISS already? But we've kind of stumbled on kind of a simple idea.
Yeah.
Something easy, but maybe controversial.
It will generate discussion, I have no doubt.
Definitely a discussion generator for sure.
Yeah.
As today we go through the entire discography of KISS. So what we're doing today is we're going down the list of all the KISS albums and we're deciding personally the best song and also the worst song on each one.
Yeah. It's going to be interesting to see what our picks are on this.
Yeah, because we're, like we always said, we're the same, but we're different.
Yeah.
So some of these might line up, and some of them are probably going to be way different. The self-titled debut album, KISS.
1974.
That's right. Awesome start.
All right.
So I'm guessing you and I probably are going to have the same best.
Well, we'll see.
Yeah?
All right, so who's going first?
I'll go first. So for KISS, the debut album, to me, the best song is Black Diamond. And the worst song is clearly KISS in Time.
I agree.
You agree with both of them?
I mean, Black Diamond's the quintessential KISS song.
It really is, you know. And KISS does some terrible covers. And it all begins with KISS in Time.
Yeah, I mean, it's... I mean, and actually, you know, the Neil Bogart from Casablanca pretty much lied to them, said that it was only going to be something used for the kissing contest promotion.
Right.
And they go in, they record it. Next thing you know, let's reissue this with this song. Oh hell no! They were basically strong armed into doing the song. It's kind of fun to listen to because it's interesting to hear them do a song like that.
Probably better than the original.
Yeah, I mean,
by virtue of it being done by KISS.
Yeah, right? I mean, I like it better than I think Bobby Rydell did the original, but no, it's a goofy song, and it doesn't really fit with the rest of the songs on here.
No, definitely not. So I guess let's move on to Hotter Than Hell. Why don't you tell me your best and worst off Hotter Than Hell?
This is a hard one to pick as far as best goes, because
really
there's a lot of great songs on this.
Cool.
For best, I'm going to go with Got to Choose. Yeah.
So what's the worst?
Worst on this one? I guess I would go with Mainline, but I do like the song.
Yeah. Baby, won't you give it to me
one time? But yeah, it's probably the most forgettable one. A lot of people pick All the Way, but I always love the hook in All the Way.
Yeah, me too.
It's a great song.
That's one of my favorite KISS songs, and definitely, I think, one of the more underappreciated KISS songs that are really good. For me, both different.
Uh-huh. I know what your number one
is. For the best, I picked Watching You.
Oh, you didn't pick Parasite.
I was thinking about Parasite. Parasite's a great song, but I really like Watching You.
Okay. Everybody else is here watching you.
And for the worst, I picked Coming Home.
It's true. I'm not sure if you knew.
Really?
Yeah. But again, this was one of them albums where it's all so good.
Yeah.
Even the worst song is a great song.
Right.
So Coming Home, I guess I'll call it my least favorite.
Yeah, but it's hard.
But it's not a song that I dislike, because I actually do like the song quite a bit.
But yeah, the first three albums are so hard to pick from.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, Dress to Kill ain't no easy.
Yeah, let's go to that one.
All right, for Dress to Kill, my favorite song off Dress to Kill is Come On and Love Me. Later, won't you take me down on my knees? You can do what you please. Come on and love me. And my least favorite song, and again, this one's difficult because I like all of them. There's nothing on here I say I hate. But I guess if I had to pick one least favorite, and I think you'll agree, it's Ladies in Waiting.
I absolutely agree.
I know you hate that song. I actually like it.
It's one of my least favorite KISS songs. All the ladies are looking fine, so fine. Ladies in Waiting. Ladies in Waiting. So that's my least favorite, too. So for my favorite, I got to go with Come On and Love Me, too. Yeah. It's just such a great song.
It is a great song. So I guess that brings us up to Destroyer.
Mm-hmm.
So for me on Destroyer, this one was tough, you know, because I like all these songs too. I got to give it to Detroit Rock City. It's legendary for a reason.
This is tough because it's between Detroit and a different one for me.
Not saying it was easy.
Yeah, I mean, just to be different, I'm going to say Shout It Out Loud. Shout it, shout it, shout
it out loud. Yeah. Both those songs are great.
Yeah, okay. You know,
but there's so many great songs on this album. Mm-hmm. And, of course, the worst song is Beth.
You really think so?
Absolutely. What's worse than Beth on this?
I think Great Expectations is worse than Beth. You don't break expectations.
Great Expectations would be second to the worst, I think.
I don't know. It's one that I liked when I was a kid, but just, I don't know. But, it's one of those in hindsight that just hasn't really aged well. But, yeah, true. I'll go with Great Expectations.
All right.
We move to Rock and Roll Over.
All right, Rock and Roll Over's up next. What do you got on this one?
Very strong record.
Yeah.
For favorite on this one, I'd probably go with I Want You. I want you. I think it's a very complete KISS song and one of Paul's best jobs of writing. He's kind of going after the Led Zeppelin Bad Company type vibe with the way he wrote this one. And so, yeah, I'd go with I Want You for the best.
I agree.
You would?
That was also my pick for the best song on Rock and Roll Over. Oh. Not easy to pick a best and a worst on this one, but for me the worst is easily Hard Luck Woman.
Really?
Yeah.
No, I don't agree with that at all.
No?
I love that song. I keep telling you, Hard Luck Woman.
Like, Love 'Em, Leave 'Em.
That's my least.
It's all right.
I don't like that song.
No.
I never have.
Yeah.
I like the music and the guitar playing, but yeah, I hate Gene's vocal on that song. It's just comical.
Yeah.
All right. So, oh yeah, Love Gun.
Yeah. So, Love Gun's next. This one was really easy for me. The best song on Love Gun, in my opinion, is I Stole Your Love. And the worst song on Love Gun, so easy to pick this one. Of course, it's
cover.
Then She Kissed Me.
For my favorite on this one, I'm going to go with the title track. Paul brags about this song a lot, and I think he should. I think it's a killer song. You pull the trigger of my love, love, love. So I'm going to go with Love Gun. For my least favorite,
there's nothing on here worse than
I don't mind Then She Kissed Me. It's not bad.
It is. It is bad, Chris.
I'm tempted to give to it's say. I'm tempted to say hooligan over then she kissed.
I don't think so. Not even close. Hooligan's way better than that.
All right, I'll go with Then She Kissed Me. But Hooligan's the next to worst, in my opinion.
All right, so let's count Alive 2.
Yeah, for the new songs.
We'll do side four of Alive 2. We'll just count the new ones. This was another one, too. I know you're going to expect me to say, oh, yeah, it's Rocket Ride.
Right.
But it actually, for my favorite song off the side four of Kiss Alive 2, it's Larger Than Life. Because that's just one of the greatest Kiss songs ever recorded.
I agree.
But really, every single one of these songs on side four of Alive 2 are great. I mean, it's so difficult to even pick one.
You mean there's not one that you don't think is great?
I guess if I was going to pick one that I didn't think was great, I would say Any Way You Want
The Dave Clark 5 cover. You know.
But even that one's all right.
It's a fun song.
Yeah.
It's cool to hear them do a 60-0 song.
Like out of all the covers that we've talked about already, this is the best one so far.
I will agree with you with Larger Than Life, but I will say Rockin' in the USA is my least favorite.
Really?
Yeah.
It's Rockin' in the USA. Nowhere else I'd rather stay. Rockin' and a rollin', rockin' and a rollin', rockin' in the USA.
I've never liked it much. It's okay. It's just, but it's a bit of a throwaway to me.
You want to do the solo albums?
Yeah.
All right, well, first one to come out was Paul Stanley. I think we're probably going to agree on this one, I'm betting.
I don't know.
I'm betting we do. So for me, on the Paul Stanley solo album, easily the best song on there is Tonight You Belong to Me. I love that song so much. And I think easily the worst song on here, this one was pretty easy to pick. Hold Me, Touch Me.
Hold me, baby, won't you touch me?
But my favorite, which has been my favorite for the past few years, has always been Wouldn't You Like to Know Me?
Wouldn't you like to know me? And wouldn't you like to show me you care?
My least favorite on this one. Yeah, it's got to be Hold Me, Touch Me. I can't really even consider anything else.
Yeah, because this one's so easy to pick a worse. It's a lot harder to pick the best song off Paul Stanley's solo album than it is to pick the worst song. I guess that's a good thing. So let's go into Gene Simmons next.
Gene Simmons, okay.
This one was a little bit trickier, I think. Not hard to pick the worst, but kind of tricky to pick the best. So, I mean, I guess easily enough, of course, the worst song is When You Wish Upon a Star.
I almost wonder if we shouldn't count that one. I mean, it's, I guess we can, but
I mean, it is.
Yeah, it's on there.
He put it on there. He's got to live with it.
Okay. So he deserves the scorn he's getting.
Yeah. And I think the best song, it's hard to pick too, but I guess I just got to go with Radioactive.
Really?
It's the hard rocking song that you'd expect. It was the most Gene Simmons Kiss-like song on the album.
That's true. My least favorite on this album is Tunnel of Love.
Tunnel of Love. Tunnel of Love. Tunnel of Love. Tunnel of Love.
I've never liked this song.
I like Tunnel of Love.
It's annoying.
It rocks, man. I like it.
And then for my favorite, this has been my favorite for a long time, Man of a Thousand Faces. I love that he wrote a song about Lon Chaney, and I love the string section on it.
Of a thousand faces,
Alright, so are we doing Ace now?
Yeah, let's go to Ace. For me on this one, for the worst... How do you pick a worst song on the greatest album?
This is the hardest thing you've had to do today.
So I guess I had to just break it down and call it Fractured Mirror. But my favorite song off the Ace Frehley solo album from 1978 is Speeding Back to My Baby.
It's a great one. So I'm going to have different picks than you on this one, too.
Okay.
For my favorite, I got to go with Rip It Out.
Rip it out! Take my heart, she wanted it. From the start, she got it now. So goodbye, so rip it out. Watch me cry.
Yes.
For my least favorite, this is going to piss some people off. I'm going to go with New York Groove.
I'm back.
I've never thought this song was all that. It's catchy, I know, but there's just not a lot to it.
The final of the four solo albums to be released in 1978, The Catman, Peter Criss. What do you got?
I'm going to go with Don't You Let Me Down. I just think it's a cool ballad, and Peter's voice is great on it.
Don't you let me down.
Don't you let me down.
Don't you leave me alone.
And it's very 70s. You know, you listen to it, it sounds like 1978.
Yeah.
For least favorite, Jesus. I'm going to go with You Matter to Me.
Of course you matter to me, and that's why. You still matter to me, and that's the only reason I leave.
Ugh. Really?
Yeah, I hate that song.
See, that's a song to me that sounds like classic AM 70s gold.
Too much though. I hate the synthesizer part in it. It's like a disco song.
Yeah,
there's plenty of other candidates for the worst song on this, but I'll go with that today.
All right, well, I disagree with you on both of those. Okay. For me, the best song on the Peter Criss solo album is That's the Kind of Sugar Papa Likes. What?
That song sucks.
It's like the most hard rocking song on the album. It's like the only song that doesn't have a lot of saxophone overkill.
That's like picking the most hard rocking song on a Bread album. Yeah.
Worst song on this album? Come on, man.
What?
You can't put the word kiss in the title. It's Kiss the Girl Goodbye.
I like that one too.
Really?
Kiss me. Kiss the girl goodbye. It's time to fly.
Kiss me.
Yeah. That's just cheesy ballads. And I mean, yeah, there's nothing. I'm not like beating my chest that I'm loving these songs, but I like them.
All right. So coming out of the solo albums, the band is back together, fully reunited. Not really.
The Return of Kiss.
The Return of Kiss.
With Anton Figg.
Right. Yeah. Brings us up to Dynasty. I'll give you one wild guess what my first favorite song is off of Dynasty.
Hard Times.
No, it's 2000 Man.
Oh, okay.
Don't you know I'm a 2000 man, and my kids, they just don't understand me at all.
And my least favorite, the worst song on Dynasty, it's the disco song,
I was made
for Loving You.
I don't really want to go with I Was Made for Loving You, but...
But you know it's...
I kind of have to.
The rest of these songs, you kind of have to.
Yeah, I'd pick that one last. Let's go... I'm going to go with Charisma.
What is my charisma? What is my charisma? What is my charisma?
That Now, if you're going to go off the beaten path, the next two albums are, is what really, really goes off the beaten path.
Right, and this one, too, was kind of tough to pick from, and it also, I think, is kind of a underrated album, you know, in its own way. Yeah, it could have been produced better. I think it could have been, some of these songs could have been heavied up a little bit and made a lot better, but they are what they are, because yeah. It was 1980, after all. I'm talking about Unmasked.
This is kind of the new wave album, I guess.
Well, for me, I think, obviously, the worst song is Shandy.
It's definitely not the worst song on this record.
You don't think so?
No. There's one that's way
Yeah.
And you're going to get way mad at me. I think
worst.
Two Sides of the Coin is just a complete turd.
Really?
I hate that song.
Two Sides of the Coin to choose from. Two Sides of the Coin, they are mine. Two Sides of the Coin, I'm getting weary. Which one should I choose? I need time.
All right, so we got our worst picks out. What's your favorite?
I guess I'm going to go ahead and bite the bullet and say I'm going to go with Naked City.
Okay. Well, since you picked Naked City as your favorite, which was, it was between that and this next one, my favorite is Tomorrow.
Tomorrow's a great song.
So let's get to... Ugh.
This one's pretty easy, I think. Music from the Elder.
I know what your favorite is.
Do you? It's Just a Boy.
You're fucking lying.
I'm Not Too Young to Be Sailing. I love this song.
You know, no. That's not your favorite.
No, it's my least favorite.
Okay.
Clearly. It's everybody's least favorite. So Just a Boy is the worst. Okay. I'm sure you agree.
Yeah, you have to pick that one.
There's nothing worse. There's nothing worse in the entire KISS catalog, I don't think.
That's debatable.
Than Just a Boy.
It's up there, though. What's your favorite?
Only You.
Only You?
Yeah, I love Only You.
Only You.
That was almost my pick for favorite. I'm going to go with Under the Rose. Happy to move on to Creatures now.
Actually, let's take a little pit stop in between because between Creatures and Music from the Elder, we got Killers.
Oh, this
that's
is
got
this,
four new tracks on it.
This is easy for a best and worst for me.
I think so too. I think you're probably going to agree with me when I say the best is Nowhere to Run and the worst is I'm a Legend Tonight.
No.
No.
The best is definitely Nowhere to Run.
Yeah.
One of the best KISS songs ever. The worst to me is Partners in Crime.
Really?
Yeah, I never liked that song.
I like Partners in Crime. I think I'm a Legend Tonight is way worse than Partners
in Crime. No, I like
that
much better than Partners.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's go to Creatures. This one's hard.
Yes, it is.
Creatures was really, really hard. Not just to pick the best, but also to pick the worst, because there's not a bad song on this whole album. You know, you can't say, easily this one's the worst song, because, I mean,
this album's a masterpiece.
It's a masterpiece. It's a complete album. It really is. Yeah. I guess if I have to pick a worst, I'll go with Keep Me Coming.
Really?
Yeah.
I love that song.
The best one, I think, is the title track.
Really?
Creatures
That's
of
great,
Night.
Too. My least favorite is the ballad. I'm not going to go with... I'm going to go with I Still Love You.
Really?
Yeah. And for the best song, I'm going to go with War Machine.
Yeah, that's a great song.
That song just kicks ass.
Hello, baby. Hi, this is Dr. Love calling, and I've got the cure you're thinking of. It's the Decibel Geek Podcast.
When I go through her,
putting the O back in rock.
It's just like a... A hotline!
Oh, yes, yes, yes!
Listening to the Decibel Geek Podcast.
Yes! Want to be a member of the Decibel Geek Army?
You slimy scumbag, get on your face and give me 25.
Join us on our fan page at facebook.com/decibelgeek.
We love you long time.
So now the next one's going to be hard to pick from too.
This one was a little easier than Creatures of the Night, I think.
Okay.
But I still had to struggle for it. I think it was easier to pick the worst song than it was to pick the best song. For me, the worst song is Dance All Over Your Face.
Agreed.
And the best song is, I guess, pick one. I'm going to go with Exciter.
It's a great one.
Yeah.
I'd go with 1,000,000 to 1. Yeah, now it's going to get interesting.
We're on to Animal Eyes. I've Had Enough Into the Fire is my favorite song off here.
Same.
It's just an amazing...
clearly the best.
Worst? Animal Eyes is an underrated album.
You know my pick for the worst.
Yeah, I know. And I'm going to go ahead and agree with you.
Oh, really?
This time, I'm going to go ahead and agree with you and say Murder in High
Murder
Heels.
Murder in High Heels. Fucking awful.
You agree with both those?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
There you go. We got one we agreed on.
Yeah. All right. So let's look at
Asylum's
Asylum.
Kind of like that. I'm going to say the worst song on Asylum is Radar for Love. Guess I think the best song is I'm Alive. Yeah.
You think that's the best song on this record?
I think so.
I think that's the worst song on this record.
What?
I think it sucks.
Really? Why?
Yeah, I just never liked it.
But it's cool.
It's just like, it's the, hey, we have to write a fast song.
They're good at it.
I don't like it.
I like it. I think it's the best song on the album.
Now, Radar for Love would have been my second choice for the worst song on here, because I think it's bad, too. For my, I think they were correct with the single choice. Tears Are Falling is an amazing KISS song. All right, on to the album that most people call their Bon Jovi attempt.
I didn't pick anything off this album.
Crazy Nights. You didn't pick anything on Crazy Nights?
No, I skipped it.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, well, you have to do it on
the fly. I refuse. No, I'm just kidding.
You dick.
So I've got one favorite song off here and 11 least favorites.
Oh.
The worst song on this album, I just hate this song so much.
Can I guess?
You already know.
My Way?
It's the worst thing ever.
But if, yeah, for the worst song, I'll go with My Way also. I think it's just, it's like two steps in the wrong direction. All right.
I'm a big fan of Thief in the Night.
Me too.
I really like that song, and that's easily the best song on Crazy Nights.
Thief in the Night. She breaks into his heart. Ooh. Like a thief in the night. She never leaves a man.
It is.
And this is another one where I'm like, where this one was actually released as a single, had a video, but did not become a hit, which I think should have. I thought Turn on the Night was a great pop rock song.
All right.
Hot in the shade.
We've made it past Crazy Nights. Yep. That's half the
It's going to get lean here in a second. So, all right. Hot in the Shade. You got 15 choices here.
I'm going to go Worst Songs Forever.
Oh, God.
Because I just don't like
Come
it.
Come on,
I
man.
I just don't like it.
Yeah, but... Come on, there's way worse on this record than Forever.
Oh, wait a minute. I forgot about Read My Body.
Yes. Read My Body is the worst song on the record.
Yeah, I
easily.
Guess you're right. Yeah, I guess you're right.
So, what's your favorite?
I'm gonna go with Somewhere Between Heaven and Hell.
Somewhere between heaven and hell. Sometimes I think you want to, but I can never tell. Somewhere between pleasure and pain.
my favorite song on here, and has been for a very long time, was King of Hearts. So, the next one, I have to think we're going to be unanimous in what we think is the best.
Oh, yeah, this one's easy. This one's so easy. It's time for Revenge.
Yeah.
Number one song off of Revenge, everybody knows it. It's Unholy.
By far.
And the worst song, that's easy too. It's Every Time I Look at You.
Mm-mm.
What?
Not for me.
No?
No.
Come on.
Every time I look at you, no matter what I'm going through, it's easy to see. And every time I hold you, the things I never told you seem to come easier.
I've never been a fan of Domino.
Really?
Yeah, I think it just sounds like a bad ZZ Top song to me. Now we go ahead 5 years.
That's wild, yeah. Big break in between.
Carnival of Souls.
Carnival of Souls is kind of tough because I really like most of what's on here. And there's nothing on here I hate.
Oh, there's one I hate.
I know there is, but I like that song. It's not my favorite, but I like it. I know which one you're talking about. We'll go first. You go ahead.
Well, the one I hate is In My Head. I've never liked it.
Really?
That song. Yeah.
I'm obnoxious and no one's home. In my head. In my head. Cardboard boxes filled with hate. In my head. They're in my head.
For my favorite, I'm going to go with Jungle.
Yeah.
A lot of people like Master and Slave better, but I like Jungle better.
Yeah, I went ahead and picked Master and Slave.
Yeah.
I like that, but I do love Jungle too.
Mm-hmm.
Least favorite song on Carnival of Souls? I'm going to go with I Confess.
You confess you can't help yourself. Can't sleep at night, you can't go on. You're possessed, you can't fool yourself. You're the crime and you can't go on.
So now it's time for the reunion record.
All right, we're definitely going to agree on this one, right?
Probably not.
No, you don't think so?
I have a weird favorite on this one.
You didn't? Oh, so you did pick I Finally Found My Way as your number one favorite
How'd
song
you know?
Off of Psycho Circus.
How'd you know?
Because I know you, man.
No. We're going to be in agreement on the worst song. Can we already say that that's both our picks for the worst song?
Well, obviously.
Okay.
I gave up everything I had and never knew. But I finally found my way. I finally found my way. I finally found my way to you.
All right, so what's your favorite?
Well, obviously it's Into the Void.
Caught like a magnet and I'm being pulled.
I'm being pulled down.
my favorite is an oddball pick. I'm picking Journey of a Thousand Years.
It's not a bad song.
And now it's all very clear. It's Journey of a Thousand Years. Can you feel it coming? Can you hear the sound?
Now the modern version of Kiss.
See, I think this is where we're probably not going to maybe even come close on any of this.
Well, let's see.
All right, well, Sonic Boom. The worst song on Sonic Boom, Danger You.
I knew you were going to say that.
Danger Me. Danger Us.
I don't agree.
You don't think it's the worst?
No, the worst in this album for me is Stand.
Stand by my side, I'll be next to you. We're gonna be there. Stand by my side and we'll make it through. We're gonna make it, yeah, yeah.
My favorite on this one is Modern Day Delilah.
Yeah, it's an awesome song. My favorite song off of Sonic Boom, and I don't know if people get mad at me for saying this, but I really like the song All for the Glory.
All right, we're down to the last one. And the last album, I don't think there's a bad song on this record.
Yes, there is.
Okay, what is it?
It's a tie.
For the worst?
It's a tie for the worst. This was one where I just couldn't pick the worst one because I couldn't decide which one was worse. The tie is Take Me Down Below and Out of This World.
I like both of them.
I'll take you on a cruise you'll never forget, she said. We better move because I'm already wet, she said.
For worst, I would probably go with Out of This World. Favorite song on here is hard to pick for me because there's so many that I like a lot.
Yeah, there are a lot of actually good songs on here. I went ahead and picked Wall of Sound.
And it all comes down to the Wall of Sound.
As far as Kiss ethos and everything, I think Freak is the best song on the record because it's basically sums up what being a Kiss fan is and what Kiss basically decided to make themselves, you know. It's a good song that kind of sums up the whole Kiss ethos. And what do you think, guys?
Yeah, exactly. You know, so you know how it works. Hit us up on the Facebook page when you see this. Of course, you want to share it, retweet it, whatever.
Yeah, make
and,
your list.
Become a Geek of the Week. But we want to know what you think. You know, if we were way off base, if we upset you, if we were right on the money, we want to know. And now we've got so many Facebook friends that we want everybody to be talking with us about it, talking with each other about it. So KISSmas in July, it's a celebration, but it's a celebration for everybody. Mm-hmm. So we invite everyone to get in on that conversation over on our Facebook page. Go do it.
Thanks for listening this week, guys.
Oh, one more thing. Mm. KISS rules.
Bitches on!